owner France. Now, he's been the best at the school figures over the past 3 years, winning them at every European and world championship. He's doing the second figure, the paragraph double three. You see it there, right there on the left. Now, he's raising his arms to show the direction in which he is going to lay the figure out in front of the judges, and there he starts. Remember, it's a two-lobed figure, two circles with two turns in each circle. Now, Scott had never beaten Simone in the figures, and going into this figure, Simone was in second place, and when he didn't live up to his usual good standard, well, the margin between the two men was increased. Going into the final figure, Scott had to keep up his standard of excellence if he was going to maintain his lead. And in this figure, the back change loop, he did just that. See once again how neat the tracings are, how precisely he did the final figure. It looks like a winner. But Christophe still had to skate the final figure. And remember, any skater can pull up, even on the last figure, and take the lead. Here you could see Simone as he traced that back change loop. Look at those circles. From this angle, you can see a very well-formed figure. How good was it? It was a first-rate one. But not good enough to take the lead. So Scott won the figures, followed by Simone and Rudy Cherney of West Germany. Brian Boitano and Mark Cockrell of the U.S. were 8 and 18.
The figure part of the competition, it's over. The results are in, and the interesting thing is that Scott Hamilton has not only won the compulsory figures, but he won every single one of those figures. What do you think, champ?
Mere words cannot express the elation I went through today on those figures. No, it went tremendous. I can't even tell you. It's always been Christophe. Christophe. I can never beat him, and he's great. And it's been something that I've been shooting for a couple years. I just want to beat Christophe in one figure, maybe two. But when I beat him today in all three, oh, that's huge. I have goosebumps.
Well, for 3 years, he defeated you. What made the big change?
I think it's because I looked at him, and I thought, this is my competition. And I knew what his figures were like. I knew he was capable of doing, and I just wanted to improve my figures to at least be as good as his. I figured if I was going to be second, I'm going to make him scrap for first. And it worked out. I wasn't that nervous today. I was thinking more about doing good figures to compete with him than I was thinking about messing up figures, which is something that you usually think about.
So you saw yourself in the chasing position rather than in the chased as far as the school figures were.
Yes, and I like it a lot better.
It's easier,
now,
isn't it?
Now I'm first and I don't have anybody to chase, but that's fine. I like it here, and hopefully the short and the long will work out.
Well, we're going to see that short program tomorrow night. One question. Are you going to be ready for it?
I'm ready.
Well, I can tell you one thing. We'll be ready.